The minimally invasive surgery in gynecological cancer is very much feasible. We call it as laparoscopic surgery, the keyhole surgeries. The advantage of minimally invasive surgery is patient gets admitted one day before the surgery and they go home in 2 to 3 days time. And they can resume their normal activity in 2 to 3 weeks after the surgery. The minimally invasive surgery is commonly done for endometrial cancer, that is uterine cancer. And most of the uterine cancers, 80% of the time, they are cured after this minimally invasive surgery. Very rarely, 20% of the cases, they may need further treatment, that is adjuvant treatment, radiotherapy, and that is usually in 3 to 4 fractions, that is vaginal brachytherapy is given. So the minimally invasive surgery is also possible in early stage ovarian cancers when the ovarian tumor is less than 8 cm size. We can remove them in an endo bag and all surgical specimens can be retrieved either vaginally or a small mini laparotomy below the umbilicus. Therefore, even in the ovarian cancers, sometimes we can do minimally invasive surgery. Patient can go home early and resume their activity very soon. The minimally invasive surgery for cervical cancer is also done when the tumor is microinvasive, very small, or if the tumor size is less than 2 cm, we can still complete radical hysterectomy and lymph node dissection by laparoscopy. When it is bigger, then we prefer open surgery. So therefore, minimally invasive surgery has lot of advantages, like the advantage of minimally surgery, which is done in other diseases. The patient has less scar, minimum pain, resumes the normal activity within few days time. That is the advantage of doing minimally invasive surgery in gynecological cancers, and that is my area of interest in gynecological cancer.